Well, another of the issues that we've been shoving under the carpet for the longest time, not discussing it, thinking that it doesn't really happen in our house. When 3 out of 5 women go through it, then it's definitely, if not your house, happening in your neighbor's house. And high time we start discussing things about it. What do you want to do about it is up to you. At least let's start the discussion. So for that sake, come on, watch Thappad. I think it'll give you a lot of points to discuss.
We have actress Tapsee Pannu with us, who's here with her latest film Thappad. Welcome to INS.
Thank you so much.
So this movie does not seem to be an easy movie.
None of my movies are easy movies, trust me. I've got nothing easy in life.
Okay.
Yeah.
What was the toughest thing then?
Everything, just to be Amrita. I am not at all Amrita in life. Like, it was claustrophobic to be Amrita because I am someone who reacts instantly, who takes charge, takes control, and doesn't take anything keeping quiet. But this one was like testing my patience because she really takes her time to be patient, analyze, is not impulsive at all. You know, analyzes all the angles before taking a decision. I'm not like that. I'm very impulsive in nature. So for me, it was very, very claustrophobic to hold on and react more sensibly than I would as Tapsee.
Right. So of course, it's a very different character as well.
It is. I mean, people think that just because I'm dealing with an issue of domestic violence, it's a cakewalk for me because they've seen me dealing with issues before in films. But you know, those films were where I was playing a firebrand, where I was playing someone who will speak her mind instantly and fight for it. This here, Amrita doesn't speak her mind that easily. She's not the fighting kinds. Otherwise, she would have slapped the guy back the day she was slapped. And that was the fear in our minds, me and Anubhav sir, because people are just so used to seeing me in these firebrand characters that they think that agar isko koi marega to she'll just instantly reply back with hitting back. And that's what is, you know, associated with me. Now to break that and make it look convincing was tough for both of us because there's such a solid image that has been made around me. To break that and make them believe something else was a challenge.
How has this film helped you to evolve as an actor?
It just, I developed a lot of patience in terms of reacting and emoting. I usually am a spontaneous actor, so I instantly react. To hold something for a longer time and vent it out at some other time is not something that I'm used to doing in life and in films so far. So this is one of the most, I don't know what to say in English, because it was sahaj characters, one of those more controlled characters that I have portrayed, which I think as a person helped me develop a lot of patience in life.
Right. Of course, if we look at your last few movies and also upcoming ones, whether it's Mithali Raj or, you know, Rashmi Rocket
them,
also, so
of
many of them, and today also one got announced, we'll come to that later. So, you tend to choose movies that have women as the hero. Is that what you're more interested in now?
No, that's what the sad myth is, because just because I choose strong characters, it's a myth that I will not do films which are like not really centrally around my character. That's why I try to take up films like Surma and Mission Mangal, you know, where I'm not the central character, because the idea is not to play the central character. The idea is to play a good character so that I can make an impact. If you give me 10 minutes also of good screen presence, I'll make an impact on my audience. But I will not say no to a film just because I'm not the central character. But I guess along with the stereotyping of doing strong roles and, you know, these kind of films, I think this is the downside that comes with it, that people believe that I will not do the films where the role is not central to the plot. And that's a myth. And I don't know, I mean, these are the films I got, so I had to choose from them.
Right.
So I ended up choosing these.
So what about the kind of offers you're getting from filmmakers? Anything different from what they want?
Everything is so different. You name a genre, I'm doing it. You name a genre. Thriller, action, sports, romance, love story, comedy also now. So you name a genre, I'm doing it.
Right.
No, even today's film, Luke Lupeta, that's a comedy thriller. It's a comedy more than a thriller. So yeah.
And one of the people who announced this was Mr. Tanuj Garg.
And he's a good friend since quite some time. I mean, whatever happened online was just not really something that I don't think he intended in that way. He was actually giving me a very sweet compliment. Just that, you know, it's time. We don't realize, no, that's what the thing is. There's a lot of things that even we as women, we say or do without realizing that this is misogynistic. So we also do a lot of things like that unknowingly. So he wanted to really compliment me, and he's been a really good friend and a very good supporter of a lot of work that I have done in the last few years. So you know, just because I had heard the similar compliment or comment from a lot of people.
Really?
Yeah. Lately I've been hearing that a lot. So and I've been saying the same thing to everyone who's been telling me this. So I just kind of wrote that also on Twitter. That just blew out of proportion.
In fact, somebody even said that, you know, you will be trolled for this. Somebody told
me. I think it's times are such that, you know, now for so many years we've been subjugated to kind of patriarchal boxed lives where we've been always compared or benchmarked based on a man. And we do, and we've been doing it very seamlessly and as if it's normal. So now when people are getting more and more aware, when something of this sort happens and someone reacts like that, that how the Pandora box opens and you just burst out because you've been just going through it for years. So the instant thing is like you just burst out when you have something like that. It's not like it is an offensive, an extremely offensive, they're worse statements that are made on social media for women. It's just that now we are so full of, you know, getting always compared to a man and living up to a man-made standard that something of that sort happens. So we just get triggered very easily.
Right. So talking about comparisons, like this movie also, the Indian adaptation of German film, Lola Rala. So are you a little nervous or something, because again there will be comparison, you know?
No, I'm not. I've done Badla before. It went well. I'm not really nervous.
Right. Okay, so talking about your lineup of movies, so many of them. How do you get in and out of characters?
I do one film at a time and I go for a holiday after every film. That's as simple and easy as that. I found out this mantra of dealing with it couple of years back when I did Pink, and then onwards I've been using this after every film of mine.
So where are you gonna go next?
I'll plan it according to when I'm getting done, wherever the weather is nice. I'm not a person who enjoys cold weather at all. So I'm more of a beach person than a mountain person. So I'll figure out which part of the world has good weather. I'll go there.
Right. And one thing I've noticed about you, you know, like other actresses, they might start off from South Indian films, and once they bag a Bollywood film, they stop doing South Indian films. But you have managed to, you know, balance both. So how is it? What's that connection that you have with South?
I think there are a lot of things. Firstly, gratitude. You know, I started there. I never wanted to be an actor. They taught me what cinema is and how acting is done, and they were the base for me to start building upon. I can't just leave that just because I've got an opportunity in Hindi. And plus, I think people there like me. I mean, they've been tolerating me for quite some time now and kind of liking my work there. So I have no reason to uproot myself from there. So now, in fact, now is a time where I have an opportunity to choose there and not just do a film because I have to keep rolling in the market. Because in the beginning of my career, when I didn't know any better, I was choosing films there just to roll in the market. So I'm not out of sight, but now it's a different time and they're offering me such good work. I might know my frequency of films has obviously reduced. I do only one film there in a year, but that one film creates an impact which is good enough to last for a year. So I think times have really changed and gone in my favor. So I have no reason to uproot myself. I think way too much of gratitude for that industry.
Never had an unpleasant experience.
Not so much so that I would want to stop working there.
Great. Thank you so much for your time. All the best for your film. It's Natalia Ningthajum for INS.